This is Surrey, though, and I think, I don't know if I talked about it with you yesterday, but in Brawling Masters, Noel was playing quite a bit of Jala, and previous before that, he was playing quite a bit of Jala as well. And specifically in Brawling Masters, his sword was looking, honestly, was looking whack.
It was.
He was looking extremely weak, extremely out of practice for some reason, which was really strange for a player like Noel, whose like claim to fame is consistency. And he's just completely turned that sword around, and we've seen today quite a bit. We've seen some great Qatar play as well, pulling out the GC Insig off stage in the end of his set earlier for a really solid kill.
But now, already getting into this match, the neutrals are connecting. I was a little confused at the beginning because I thought it was a button check because of how many moves they were missing. But that was just how well they were dodging each other's openers. Little Cap seeming to get a little bit of an advantage here after that neutrals are connected. Noel has to recover back into the stage, tries to cover it with a nice side light. Noel, however, gets that down air. Okay, put into kill percent. Gravity cancels side light from the sword. Gets some control back over the center stage, and Little Cap gets disarmed.
What are these signatures coming out from Noel? He's placing them so well. The damage is deadly even right now. Nice weapon toss to continue that string. Noel doing a great job in the neutral game, picking up the kill there.
Okay.
Nice lead for him coming in about a minute into this game so far.
Little Cap started off strong, but Noel was able to find the finishing blow, and now looking for a weapon to come back. Noel is trying to get something started with the Qatars. Qatars definitely a lot better than Bo against that arm.
Yes. And I think that's specifically one of the things Noel said, is he actually really likes when people are unarmed into his Qatar. He doesn't feel at a disadvantage like he does when people are playing unarmed into the Bo, which is why he's straying away from that Koji pick.
Weapon toss aside, picked up that sword. We've been seeing so many of these with sword players in general, but I want to highlight specifically what Noel's doing. Great nair from Little Cap, and Noel is putting a lot of gravity canceled neutral lights and side lights just above the ground.
GC and side light. Ooh, I love it so much.
It's cool because on sword, right, you travel that set distance.
Yes.
But when you use it in the air, you kind of travel at an angle a little bit down towards the stage.
It covers a little bit down. You fall a little bit when gravity takes hold on your actual character. So yeah, it covers a grounded opponent. It can cover a slightly aerial opponent. It can cover an opponent on his way up to that jump, but Lil Cap just all of a sudden has evened up so much damage.
Who
big
shares,
slaps, though, coming out from Noel. Lil Cap just not going to have enough in-air movement option, and just like that, it went from even to very much in Noel's favor in a heartbeat. Now, Noel's edge guards started off today, it seemed like he just wasn't focusing on them. That wasn't going to be a part of his playstyle. If his opponent goes off stage, he's really not going to chase them off there for any more than one hit, but he's committing here, but he's doing it very safely.
Yeah, succeeding in almost all of his offstage game. Little Cap has been, when put into a situation where there was an edgeguard possible, it succeeded for Noel. Good stops there. Weapon toss is dodged out of the way. Noel makes it back, and that ground pound puts Little Cap
beneath
the stage.
Oh, that was a commitment. He is able to get under. That is something with all the in-air movement that you have. You can use your dodge in the beginning, then use your jumps, use your recovery, and then you might get a dodge off of cooldown towards the end. So you are able to chase under the entire stage here for the escape to get away from your opponent. But I don't know if he's going to be able to get away from Noel for much longer. That signature coming in. Lil Cap's going to be able to dash in D-Light side air for the punish. Almost going to pick up the kill, but Noel's able to get back, saving his dodge until the end. D-Light into the gravity cancel, neutral heavy.
And not even saving his dodge towards the end. He used his dodge first while recovering. And that's taking advantage of that recovery.
Yes.
Dodges, you don't just have one of. The recovery is just, I think it's 3 seconds instead of the shorter dodge time they have on the ground. Used that first, made it back, waited until it came back up so that he could touch the wall, because if he didn't use that dodge right away, which some players don't think about doing in the heat of battle, especially when you're getting hit that hard by like
an
Amorsair, he was able to make it back with that decision making. So really good by him. D-Light recovery coming out to be able to finish it up. And we're seeing that Little Cap Legend switch, that pocket pick Atori that he picks when he's feeling like he's struggling a little bit too much with Bodvar at the beginning, and he wants to throw his opponent off for a loop while he figures out what he's fighting against.
Yeah, and you and I were talking just a little bit about this earlier, like when we got here in the arena and we saw Phazon and Lil Cap playing against one another.
Yeah, we thought it was Phazon playing.
Yeah, and I don't think it was.
No, it wasn't.
So, it wasn't Phazon playing Atori.
Little Cap
so
is definitely preparing this. It's something that he's got whenever the Bodvar's not feeling right. The match isn't close enough, and obviously that one wasn't. But Noel going for that gravity cancel, neutral signature does not quite connect. And now the sword ditto continues, jumping down air to cover that platform. D-Light drops the follow up, doesn't find that Sarah afterwards. A little unusual for Little Cap, and Noel was able to get control over center stage again.
Now maybe he was trying to go for that like wonky, unorthodox follow ups like we saw towards the end of Little Cap's last set, where he was hitting stomps on the hammer, but he wasn't wasn't following up with the side airs, even when his opponent was in kill percent.
It's true.
So maybe he's just going for
that unorthodox play. I might also just think that he might not be putting the input in. There's a possibility.
Okay.
High stakes, because I would feel like, why wouldn't you want to get a confirmed hit?
I know,
yeah,
right?
But right.
Locap did it so many times,
and
though.
And he succeeded.
The end of that set was just such a big question mark for me. And, I mean, even the Satori pick is a little bit of a question mark, just because Locap has been so dedicated. Picks up
that
D-Light into the recovery. He absolutely does.
And now cycling these weapons, making sure that he can hold on to the spear as Noel is waiting for a weapon to roll. But oh, the same D-Light. Well, it actually wasn't D-Light recovery. There was D-Light, gravity cancel, neutral sit.
Yep.
Coming out to be able to get that KO off the top. Great finisher by Noel. Evens things up right away. And the unarmed actually winning out here against Noel's guitarist. Noel finally gets in after two neutral lights. Good side light into neutral light from him into a weapon toss. Picks up a second pair of guitars. Tries to catch him as he's hiding on that platform just a little bit too high with that neutral signature. But the side light in the nair puts a little cap off stage. Little cap still hasn't picked up a sword. He's been fighting unarmed against these guitars. And surprisingly, didn't take as much damage as it looked like he was taking.
Qatars typically have a very low damage per hit.
Oh.
So even if you're hitting like one hit, wait, one hit, wait, one hit, wait, that's not a high damage output. Even if it seems like you're winning all of these trades and everything, that's probably why he wanted to go over to the sword. You're going to have higher damage per hit. You're going to still have strength potential.
Oh,
you're going to have kill potential as well with moves like that Sare. He's going to go for
the
dare, almost getting caught under the stage, but you didn't see him panic too much. Once he bumped his head, he was still able to get back up. And this is a very sizable lead going the way of Noel. This is looking like all of his other sets today, except for the one against Wrenched.
Now, that being said, Little Cap had a sizable deficit against Viper in a similar fashion, 0-2 as well.
Yes.
And he was getting dominated just like this. And it wasn't until game three happened that Little Cap was able to adjust and turn it around. Perhaps he could do it during this game, however, because he gets that Haymaker, sends him off the stage. Nice recovery, but it's not enough.
He's
Noel was only
one
in orange when these signatures hit. He waits out the dodge, gets a nice neutral light, and the recovery again follows him all the way towards the top. Little Cap almost going in entirely unarmed here. And what Noel was afraid of fighting with his Koji, he's ending up fighting and losing two in game number two here on the Asuri. But he still has a slight lead. But Little Cap's turning that around very quickly here with the sword. No Sare follow up, no jumping. Okay. All right. Noel was going for that downer, maybe trying to get a reset into the nair. Doesn't connect. And Little Cap is now put it back into neutral. But good weapon toss and a neutral sig read into Sare. Noel has get the reverse neutral sig out of the stage. He's going
almost
for the third. Little Cap is just like, okay, screw the sword. I'm just going to keep fighting with the unarmed because that's what's working the best for me. D-Light dropped, though. So many D-Lights are being dropped, and Little Cap makes it back. Has the spear, puts Noel on the side of the stage. Might be able to find some neutral lights. There's the first. Goes for that pogo stick, but goes too deep. Doesn't connect. Noel finds a D-Light Sare. Another one of those will definitely finish it. Will he get a down air? He does finish it off. Noel, a reasonable lead there. A nearly 200 damage lead as he's able to take that game number two. And he is feeling comfortable. He only has to win one more game to get into top three, into losers finals, to fight the loser of Wrenched and Boomy over on winners final side. And Little Cap, he's in a familiar place.
The exact same thing. Game one was Bodvar, it was a loss. Game two was Satori, it was a loss. Game three, Bodvar win. Game four, Bodvar win. Game five, Bodvar win. He's looking for a similar formula here against Noel with this game three Bodvar pick going back, except he's not switching to the Nutcracker Bodvar like he did before. So a little bit of a difference in the skin choice here. He's going back to the old mainstay, the classic Lil Capped, this purple big rig Bodvar. He's got to find something here. He's down two games. He's come back from this before, and this is the first time we've seen Black Art today?
I think in top eight, yeah, for sure. And it's definitely one of the jankiest stages that you can go for. It has, if you were just to look at the stage alone, right, center stage, top platform, that's normal, but you got this weird little piece of land floating off to the left. And the same thing isn't happening on the right, so it makes the dimensions of the box.
It's an asymmetrical map.
Yeah, asymmetrical map indeed. And perhaps it's a way to play it around, because when the platform dips down low, you can kind of use the wall, similar in Twilight Grove, as a combo tool. So perhaps they'll be able to do that. But right now, they're just worried about controlling center stage. Those are those neutral sticks that Noel likes to throw out. Little Cap returning with his own, both whiffing. And now, a little bit of a lead for Noel, but so far, rather even trades. Down air comes out, no connection, and Noel's looking pretty okay on this Asuri. I'm wondering if he wants to toss the sword away, get a nice little unarmed combo going towards his guitars. That side stick was so close. No punish from Little Cap. Down air comes out. Noel spot dodges, expecting some sort of follow-up. Weapon toss is being exchanged, and still no sizable damage on either side of the board.
If Noel wins this game, he will be moving on 3-0 over LoCap in the losers finals, guaranteeing himself a top three placement. LoCap is still able to get back. Noel's not going to find the early lead just yet. He has just a little bit of the damage lead, but that's negated by LoCap's side sig right over the edge. Utilizing that kind of AoE blast that it has sort of
when it connects with the ground or the air, regardless, it always has that green energy that you see with all Bodvar moves.
Yes.
That also is really damaging on top of the weapon itself. Manages to catch Noel sliding up the side of the stage as his attempt to recover. And now he has a lead here in game number three. Good recovery. Picks up this weapon. Sword. Tries to find a side air. No, the down air. Well, ground pound interrupted by the recovery from Noel. Sends LoCap off the side of the stage. And that Nair has a sizable amount of knockback at this percentage. He's getting his recoveries back, but I don't think he did. Okay,
he did touch. Yeah.
Oh, no. Ground pound. Gravity cancel Neutral does not pick him up. Doesn't carry him to the stage. That recovery just barely not killing him because of how deep beneath the stage that he was. And Noel can't find the falling stairs. A D-Light Sarah will definitely do it, but LoCap's finding so much damage before losing this first stock.
He's finding those weapon toss initiations. Goes for the raw side heavy.
Oh, two recoveries.
For the haymaker there. Double recovery coming out. What? You see him immediately throw the hammer away. I was expecting a side air there, but maybe he's looking for something different. He's trying to juggle Noel off the top. Just standing completely still. Noel is not thrown.
Didn't work.
Dash in, D-Light recovery for the kill. Noel's taking so much damage in the meantime. You see him jumping very, very high, throwing that weapon when he's off screen, waiting for it to hurtle down to the ground with the force of gravity, almost on fire, moving so fast like a rocket returning from orbit, but now Noel is the one sent off into orbit by that recovery coming out from LoCap. Good thing he's on Space Station Gaming.
A little bit about LoCap and when he was standing still there. The reason why we laughed so hard about that is because, LoCap with a nice neutral stick. Two neutral sticks in a row. He will do these standstill tactics, and normally it throws off his opponents a lot, but Noel, going in there with that downlight into recovery immediately after watching him, what an excellent option to be able to adapt to his opponent's playstyle, but LoCap so far ahead because of that first stock is finding so much.
Oh my god, Noel, no!
Okay, all right.
So look at LoCap's smug little face off of that.
Let's say this is your first time watching Brawlhalla, okay? So heavy attacks aren't just heavy attacks. You can charge them, similar to like smash attacks in Super Smash Brothers. And he fully charged that smash. now, normally you don't see players do that because it's not considered good, very easy to react to, and it is very punishable. However, LoCap is a genius. And Noel wasn't ready for that long of a charge. In fact, maybe he didn't realize they could be charged that far. But either way, that was more than enough to take out his opponent there. And an excellent game win from LoCap. Now it's 2-1, and LoCap is doing what he did to Viper, potentially. Not winning out so far here. His side stick interrupted by that neutral stick from Noel and the falling down air. D-Light comes out. Doesn't get that neutral light, and Noel is actually kind of bopping LoCap here in this game number four.
Almost getting hit by that weapon toss that would have confirmed the kill, and exactly as you said, beautiful signature. Noel has taken less than 30 damage on this stock. Very, very little damage taken so far. He seems to just be dominating LoCap so far in the neutral game. That's going to be the one, the air of just being very, very confident in his abilities after falling prey to that side signature fully charged. Noel's going to want to come out of the gate, hit the ground running on this, get a huge lead, maintain that lead, and play safe because he knows LoCap likes to bring out goofy, unorthodox things, switch up the timings with those signature charges, and it looks like Noel is keeping it going. Nice spot dodge, doesn't get the signature follow, gets punished just a little bit, taking two hits from LoCap.
I'm liking the Nairs. He's pivoting them so that the hammer will be able to reach towards where Noel is trying to dodge around him. Got a little bit more damage at side stick that he connected with twice in the previous game. Not working up with the ground pound.
Oh.
Excellent ground pound by LoCap, being able to take out that stock in orange. And what was looking like such a horrible lead for Noel is a little bit closer here, as LoCap's only in orange, and the hammer can put on a lot of damage to be able to find three, maybe four D-Light Sairs. Good sidelight starter. He's trying to get these down airs, maybe lead him into a neutral air from the hammer. Not being able to quite get those downers, though, scooping against the ground, and Noel is just kind of skirting around it. No damage really found on either side.
Yeah, huge whiffs coming out from everybody so far. Nobody wants to commit too hard and take too much damage. Noel coming out, that was the first big commitment that we saw in the past few seconds alone, coming out with that big down signature. A lot of active frames there. LoCap committing with that neutral signature as well. Neither one hitting so far. D-Light, there's the recovery. That'll kill. That might not have killed. Definitely wouldn't have killed on Blackguard. Wouldn't kill on Blackguard.
That's unique to this.
Great Hall. Probably wouldn't kill on any other map in this game except for Small Brawl Haven.
The benefit of picking this map if you're trying to get some very early KOs, and LoCap's now on tournament stock. If he loses this, he's out of the tournament in fourth. Noel, hungry for that top three placement, perhaps even the grand finals. trying to get these downers onto Little Capped. He can't find anything. Okay, jumps down, doesn't go for a downer for a quick punish, but instead a neutral light to extend the punish potentially. But a neutral light missed once again, and Noel finds his own. Falling Sarah, weapon toss, forces the dodge. Can he find the other ground pound? It goes too deep. Noel's able to find this down air on the sword, puts Little Cap deeper into orange, has that hammer, stomps Sarah, gets the KO.
That was an early kill, too. That was like on the border.
That's
between
all we're going to be seeing.
Orange and red. That's something that Little Cap's hammer is going to be able to do so effectively here. He's going to have more kill potential with that than Noel will be able to. That's why you're seeing Noel find these signatures, because they will give him those earlier kills. Stomp sidelight.
Okay.
Almost picks up the nair. Stomp almost picks up the dare. He's finding some damage getting through that signature.
No,
he's doing the same thing again.
It's got to be intentional this
time. It absolutely is.
Well, I mean, after your first two stomps miss the follow-up, why not? You just stomp and wait, because that's basically what's happening. You can get a second grab.
Oh!
He gets it. All right. Game number five. Little Cap somehow pulling out these games out of nowhere and bringing it to a game five against Noel. Is this going to be another reverse 3-0? What is it with Little Cap and looking like he is complete trash compared to the opponent in the first two games, and then bringing out something that nobody is expecting? Little Cap, known to be a twos player,
yes,
known to place top three in twos and not really do much at ones, is about to get into top three at DreamHack Montreal. It is game number five. Noel is looking over his options. We might see a legend swap, because I mean,
he hasn't locked in yet.
Yeah, he's thinking about it, because he's been going there the entire time. I like the argument that you were giving me that he gave you about the unarmed stuff, but the unarmed's working anyways. That's the thing. Little Cap's been getting a lot of unarmed opportunities, and now that hammer seems to be the scariest thing. He locks into the Asuri. We're going to map striking. No legend swaps from either character. Game number five is coming up in Small Brawl Haven.
Still
while
on the
working
table.
In Noel's favor, definitely ended up providing Little Cap the way to stay in that game, because the leads that Noel was getting was in damage, but damage is the one thing that really doesn't matter on Small Brawl Haven. But we're going back. This is game number five. This is it.
Three,
this is for top
two,
three.
One,
loser is out at fourth. Noel versus Little Capped in loser semis finals.
Ooh, Little Cap picks up a nice nair to start it off with. Immediately gets to the weapon. He's going to keep Noel weapon starved, immediately throwing his sword away as well. Picks up the hammer. We saw what he was able to do with the hammer. And it's so weird that only towards the end of the games and the possible ending of a set, does Little Cap bring up those wonky stomps?
Yes.
He wasn't doing that at all until the end of that game. He was going for stomp side airs, stomp dares when Noel was stacked so a side air wouldn't hit. But only at the end does he do whatever those stomps are.
Yeah. And the more that I think about it, oh, excellent down signature from Noel. He tries to get that ground pound, but interrupted by that nair. That hammer nair reaches so far up vertically. Noel trying to get back onto the stairs. The stomps are coming out again, and there's a stomp side light. And I was thinking, the stomps could have a tactic in the sense that, what's the first thing you're going to do as a player that's so used to being hit by stomps there? Try to spam the dodge button.
Yes,
crazy
absolutely.
To get out of it. So if you stomp and you wait and they dodge, that is that much longer, like 3 seconds, that they can't do anything. But the downstick from Noel, unfazed by all these weird stomps coming out, has a similar lead like he did in game number four. But we now know that means nothing on Small Brawl Haven. Noel in the lead, however.
There's a weapon spawn on the field. If I'm not mistaken, it will be a sword, so Lil' Cap won't quite have the kill potential.
He's getting hit by so many D-like combos.
Even if it is a hammer, he still might not have the kill potential. If Noel keeps him away, we're seeing some big damage coming out from Noel. Has Lil' Cap in the orange at this point. Lil' Cap over, trying
down
to resort
to
the wall. Beautiful signature coming out from Noel. Lil' Cap does answer back with a side air. What is his edgeguard option right over the corner going to be? You see him kind of probing with these downlights, trying to reach out as far as he can, waiting for Noel to peek up. You're seeing wall slip almost coming into effect. The longer that Noel spins on that sidewall, once he gets to like 12 or 14 jumps, touching the wall will not reset his jumps. He doesn't actually get the kill with that, though. He's almost fighting himself with a two-stock lead against Lil' Cap. That is going to be the two-stock lead right there. Noel in a wonderful position.
I was so convinced that D-Light Neutral Sig was going to be able to get that KO.
I did too.
Noel just found the same option again with a different weapon. Excellent job, and now he has two stocks ahead from Little Cap. Little Cap, this is the kind of miracle we didn't see against Viper, right?
Yeah.
The match was a lot closer.
Oh,
Noel,
my gosh!
With those ground pounds, has to recover low. Is he going to recover at all? Wait, Little Cap just falls instead of using a ground pound on the way down.
Noel still
manages
going,
to get
dude.
The advantage. Hammer is here, but Little Cap, okay, weapon toss. Is he going to go for that downer? Maybe a ground pound? No, Little Cap can't risk it. If he risks it and he gets hit by a sword down air on the way down, that's it for his tournament life. He has to play this and not get hit for three whole stocks from Noel, and it's already failing.
This has to be literally flawless from now on. Oh, the down signature almost killing. It was all the way on the right side of the stage, sending all the way to the left. The weapon toss. Noel's going to dodge through it. The D-Light. Little Cap didn't immediately go for the ground pound because Noel was in an interesting spot there. So the D-Light sent him high. Little Cap had the timing, the reaction. reaction times to notice Noelle's
that. Noelle's definitely looking for this down light setup on armed. Okay, pick the guitars instead. And now finding that Nair, Little Cap's going to have to get probably the best series of hammer ground pounds ever. Okay, well, he disarmed.
And that is it. No game five victory for Little Cap this time around, but still placing the best in singles that he has ever placed on land.